please ignore that. Sometimes I say things that I'm like, we should not say those things in public. Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. And today another FIFA Women's World Cup eye look. Because the Dutch ladies are playing against Japan tonight in the, I think it's the 8th final. They need to win this, otherwise they are out of the game. So yeah, it kind of depends on them if there will be another installment of this eye look series or not. So this is the look I came up with today. Yes, I know it kind of resembles the French flag. But you know, there are only so many ways that I can kind of put red, white and blue and orange on my eyeballs. So yeah, I do really like how it turned out though. Let me know which one of the four looks is your favorite. Oh, and before we go any further into the video, let me kind of say sorry about the ambient noise. But yeah, they are working on the sewage system here and they started filming right around the time I was wrapping up the video. So yeah, most of the time you don't hear them, but now and at the ending, you do. But what can you do about it, you know? I used 3 eyeshadow palettes today. I used the Ready Set Summer from Max Up the Makeup for the dark blue there and the red here. Both are mattes. I used the Slush palette from September Rose Cosmetics for the orange and this orange. Those two oranges. And I used that white, which is a little bit shimmery. You don't have to use the exact palettes that I have though. If you have a dark blue matte, a red matte and a white, well, either a matte or a little bit of a shimmery shade. It could be your face highlighter, you're all set to go. And then an orange matte or maybe an orange eye pencil, you know, something like that. The Disco Queen palette from Exposed Cosmetics, I grabbed this orangey shimmer shade. So it's totally optional. But yeah, as always, everything that I used on my face will be down in the description box below. I wish you a lot of fun watching and I will see you at the ending. Good morning. It is so freaking warm in here. I'm almost melting. But yeah, because it is so warm, I think it's going to be 35 degrees Celsius here. And it is in the room I'm filming in 29 degrees already. And it is almost 8 o'clock in the morning. So yeah. Because my face is going to melt off, probably, I'm going to keep it quite simple today. I want a light orangey eye, light orange, and then kind of a wing, and then a pop of orange in the inner part of my eyeball. That is basically what I want to do. I'm using 3 palettes, the Slush palette, the Ready Set Summer palette from Max Up the Makeup, and the Disco Queen palette that I have been using, but I'm starting with the Slush palette for the color Peach Lemonade, which is this one. And that is going to go on my lid as a light layer. They are playing against Japan tonight, so yeah, they need to win this game, otherwise they are out of the World Championships. It's pretty late. It will be, they'll play at 9 o'clock tonight. So I kind of hope that I can stay up for it because, yeah, 10 o'clock is about my bedtime. So yeah, I probably will though. It will probably be very, very exciting. So yeah, that is kind of what I want, isn't it? And you know, if it is up too high, I can always clean it up with a bit of concealer. But for now, I think we are good. I want it a little bit on my lid, just a wash. I am going to make a concealer wing in a minute. And a lot of you guys really liked my look from yesterday's video, my Let's Talk Makeup video, which was done with this palette, by the way. I really liked it too. And it is a, I don't know, I have dust in my coffee. It's a very nice, kind of almost effortless look if your eyeliner wants to play nice though. Okay, let's put an orangey eyeliner in my waterline real quick. This is the ColourPop Creme Gel Liner in a Poppy. I just received this from one of you because one of you sent me another goodie box from ColourPop, so thank you so freaking much for that. It just still blows my mind, you know. I'm also going to pop it in my inner corner for the as a base for the shimmer later. Oh, now I'm looking sexy. As usual. Please ignore that. Sometimes I say things that I'm like, we should not say those things in public. I am going to dip in to the Max Up the Makeup palette because the blue in there I have worked with and I know how easily I can work with it basically. It's called Coast, it's there, it's a dark blue, but I can really nicely sheer it out. I did that yesterday. I just tap in the brush lightly. I'm just going to darken up the outer corner and a tiny bit in the crease to create a little bit of definition. I don't know what the blue and the orangey will do, but we will see. And it also gives a little bit of a base for the wing later. And this is what I mean by this shadow blends really, really nicely. I'm kind of switching mirrors to the one that I have, so I'm looking down a little bit, and the one that's right in front of me, so I can kind of see how it is looking when I look straight ahead. Okay, let's get a fluffy clean brush and blend over everything. Okay, now let's go with my wing thing. So I'm basically just going to create a wing but with concealer. So let me get another mirror for that. I don't know if I can talk while I'm doing this, and I hope you can see what I'm doing because yeah. I hope I can see what I'm doing. And when I get to the outer part, I'm going to kind of look forward and then stamp. Now when I look down, you can see that I have a part missing. I'm going to stretch my eye and drag it down. Like that. Now I'm going to try and fill it in, but it could very well be that I need a smaller brush for that. But let's see. So you could either go straight ahead like that, or you can do what I'm going to show you. I don't know if I will fill it in later, we will see. So I'm looking straight ahead, and I'm looking straight ahead, and I'm actually going to drag it to my eyelid. But then when I look down, you can again see a little piece missing. You can fill that in. You can do a whale tail and then kind of stamp it like that. And then nicely fill it in like that. You can do whatever you want, basically. Trouble is, though, now that I have kind of gone over the blue, does not really matter though. I do need a different brush, however. Does not really matter because I'm going to put blue there anyway. I'm trying to get my brush as thin as possible so I can kind of make a nice... It does not want to play nicely though. Of course not. And then you just keep checking to see if it is the way that you want it to be. Maybe you want the wing a little bit more high. Maybe you do want to connect it all the way. You know, it's just the way you want it to be. Have fun with it. I am, however, really stretching my eye because it's a bit older, you know. Now I'm just dragging over everything to make sure that it is nice and the way I want it to. So I think this is looking okay. Yeah, I think this is looking cool. So, cool. I am going to put on red. I'm going to clean the brush I just used because I'm going to use that one again because it's nice and small. I am going to go into the color Heatwave, this nice red in the Max Up the Makeup palette. Probably going to create a lot of fallout. I am going to spray my brush. Why, you may ask? Well, to kind of help against fallout. That's basically it. Going to stamp that in the beginning of my concealer. And you can spray mattes. We used to spray mattes back in the day to get them to be a bit more... Well, basically more, because the shadows were not that great. Yeah, I think that's nice. So I have a brush for my dark blue. Let's use the color Coast again from the Max of the Makeup palette, that one. That's going to go on the outer part of the wing. And again, I'm going to spray this shade. I could theoretically have used a different brush. This one is nice and stiff, so I can use this one really nicely for the end part that I have here. I'm changing to a slightly different brush. This one is just a small flat brush to fill everything in a bit more, hoping this is not too big. I'm actually dragging it a little bit more in just because of the shape of when I look forward, so you have something interesting, you know, to look at. Okay. I left a brush. I can use a different brush, I think, if I can find it. Yes, where's my lip brush? Yes, so I have here a lip brush. I'm just using very, very small brushes, just so you know. I'm going to go into the color Coconut Milk from the Slush palette, which is this one, which is a white. It's not really a shimmer, but it's not really a matte either. So it is, well, it is a shimmer, it's not foil. Does that make any sense? I don't know. I'm going to spray it as well. It's going to go into the center. And yes, I'm well aware that this looks like the French flag, but there are only so many ways I can put red, white and blue on my eyeball. You know? Trying to be creative, people. Okay, red, white and blue. Yes, they kind of need to blend a little bit. Don't you agree? I'm taking a small brush, clean, just going to try and kind of blend the two together a bit. Let's kind of dip into the color Coast a tiny bit and kind of press it a little bit over that white. Then a little bit of the white. Press it a little bit and blend it over the blue. So it's kind of sandwiched between, you know? Cleaning the brush, and I'm going to attempt the same with the red and the white. So dip into the red a tiny bit. And then into the white. I want that white color a little bit more in. So I'm just pressing it on top of that red. A little bit of that red. A little bit more into my eye. I think that's fun. So let me do that on the, let me do that on the other eye as well. Then I will do my face and then I will be back and we can finish off the eyes and that will be it for today's look. So hold on tight, I'll be right back. Okay, I want to show you what I'm doing because I think you will appreciate that. I've put down the colors here. I am going to take a tiny bit of the color Coast, which was that dark blue, on my, what is it, Morphe M507 brush. I'm going to pull that in a tiny bit, because I lost that blue that I put down, and I kind of like that, so I'm very, very lightly stretching my eyeball, and then kind of flicking it forward a little bit, and then pulling a little bit into the crease. To create, I don't know, the same that I have here, you know, just a kind of a nicer flow without losing that sharpness of the, yes. Then what I did here is I cleaned the brush and then a tiny bit of the coconut milk, which was that white, and lightly put it kind of besides it so that you can create that kind of shape. I hope I make sense, people. Now, obviously, I kind of need to finesse this, but it's going to look the same as it is here. So let me do that. So here is the look just before my falsies, and I wanted to show it to you real quick so you can see what it looks like with just mascara. I have not done anything yet to the bottom lash line. I will go and put on my falsies now. Then I will put a little bit of, well, stuff on my lash line, but you will see what I do. But first, let me put on my falsies. Yes. Oh, and if you hear scraping, it's not that someone is burying a body or digging something up. They are working on the sewage system here. So just so you know. And of course they are doing it while I'm filming. Okay, finally, falsies are on and lippy is on. Let me do the lower lash line real quick. I want an orangey. Sorry for the noise, but I just want to finish up the video. So yeah, I'm going to go into the color Mango, which is this one from the Slush palette. It is a little bit shimmery, but that does not really matter. That is going to go underneath my lash line to kind of smoke it out. I don't want a bright orange hole, but I do want a little bit of orange there. For the inner corner, I am going to go to the Disco Queen palette for the shimmery orange I have here. It's going to go in the inner corner, and then basically the look is done. That's cute. So that is the look. That is it. That is it for the, I think it's number 4. Yes. So yeah, let's hope there will be a number 5, but that kind of depends on how they play tonight, doesn't it? Yeah, guys, let me know down below what you think of this look. Let me know if you have a favorite of this series, and I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening, and I hope to see you in my next one. Bye, guys.